Hello guys, this is the new thermistor for the VRV 3, that day error code J5. So we buy the new thermistor for this one. So now we go and replace this thermistor. After that system running or not need to check. So we buy DAIKIN from spare parts from DAIKIN. So VRV 3 DAIKIN condenser unit, we need to go replace this one first. Here have five thermistor have R2T, R4T, R5T, 6T, 7T, totally 5 thermistor for one connector pin. We better replace for that day J5 means R2T section 5 thermistor only spoiled. So now we just replace together every thermistor also. Better this one all together coming one connector pin only everything thing, so we just replace all one. So after, before we replace, we just checking the new thermistor sensor reading. So we check with the multimeter. From the multimeter we just put ohm value. We just check the one thermistor have two wire, so this one is one thermistor, another one is thermistor, so 5 thermistor have. We check the thermistor how much the value coming, the new thermistor one. So we check with the multimeter, so how much the value coming, we check. Now I show you how to measure the resistance value of the thermistor. So this is the 6 wire have, so we take 2 wire. We just put the multimeter to ohm value. So we put ohm value. After that, we the 2 pin. Just we put the multimeter, the knob, connect the wire, and then we show how much the reading. This one clear, this one. Coming here. Now the value is 19.0 kilo ohms. The at room 25 degree Celsius, room temperature is 25 degree Celsius, the value is 19.71. We measure another one. See, another one also same, 19.56. Same the old one also, we just measure the value is the different. This one is not good one, just replace the new thermistor. So we like this, we take out and measure one by one. After which one is no good, just we replace this one. This is the correct one. From the wiring diagram we can see the thermistor R2T is the section, R3T is the discharge means this one is the normally I already show the video J3 error code. This one is not coming, this thermistor. So R2T is the suction, R4T is the heat exchanger, R5T is the heat exchanger outlet, R6T is the liquid pipe thermistor, R7T is the accumulator. So this 5 sensor now we to replace from this wiring diagram. So I show you the first R2T is the, this one is the this sensor is the R2T. This sensor is the R2T suction pipe thermistor. Normally this sensor is problem, so we just replace this one but cannot, because this one connected together with five sensors, so we replace all the sensors. This one is R2T sensor, and then this one is the R40. R40 means the heat exchanger sensor. This one is R40. This one normally the same like the pin, same clip, same. Same like the clip, same like take out. This one is the R40 sensor, and this means the heat exchanger sensor. And then this one is heat exchanger outlet sensor. This means R5T. R5T is the heat exchanger outlet. Normally the heat exchanger is CU condenser coil. It absorbs the heat, the gas become liquid. So this is the heat exchanger sensor. So this one R60 is the R60. This one is the R60. This one is R60. R60 means this one liquid pipeline thermistor. This one liquid pipeline thermistor. This one R60. So we just take out. Another one is the accumulator. This one is accumulator sensor. R70 is the accumulator sensor. So we now this one is old one. We check, just take out and replace the new one. So we check, just take out. Already I just take out, I just tell you. This one is the connector pin of the good. So this one is the old one. Just now we take out one. This one is the buy new one. So we just replace the new one. Buy one. We just put back ready the put back the sensor. The white color one is the R2T sensor. They just put back ready. And then the see this one is the heat exchanger, also just put back the heat exchanger outlet, also I just put back the small new sensor. After that the accumulator, new one accumulator sensor, just we put back. And then the liquid pipe sensor also I just put back. So everything we put back, after we just nice cable tight tighten, after we just put back the new one, everything I put back. After just we on back the unit, going to test on the unit, system can be run. So now the show you how to the five type of sensor, just we from the VRV3 unit. So we just on back the unit. So this is the isolator. So we just on back the unit. The light also now blinking. This will wait for few minutes, few seconds or few minutes. The system should be run. Still the number two light is same blinking. The number two light is automatic off, the automatic the system can run. So wait for few seconds or few minutes.
ready.
So now the fan is running. So for this J5 Echo, we just replace the echo sensor. The system should be okay now. Some of few seconds the compressors automatic pick up. So now the error code is for over. The error code is from this thermistor. Now we replace the J5 error code, the sensor, everything. Now the system should be normal mode. Now system is running. So for the error code, we replace the thermistor. Thermistor okay now.